The pace of life moves so quickly, you don't really take time to appreciate it. My story was something of that sort, until stage 4 colon cancer created a pause, or better yet, my purpose.
It's a brand new day. The God that we serve has allowed us to open our eyes, to take another breath, and for that, we give him praise.
You heard it. What's going on, world? Back again with another vlog. I know it's been some time since I dropped another vlog, but a lot of things have been going on health-wise, and I think that it was best that I dedicated all my time to that. But today is the last day of radiation for me. And I don't know if I told you guys before, but like I said in the beginning of the vlog, the name of the vlog is From the Heart of Tris. Anything I say is from the heart. And that also goes with being transparent with what I'm going through. So with that being said, I had to start doing radiation due to the fact that the chemo wasn't working that I was on. Some tumors started to grow again. So I did some radiation to try to get some control over that. But in between my last vlog and today's vlog, a lot of stuff has been going on. A lot of amazing things have been going on. On October 19th, I had my biggest fundraiser of the year, No Battle Should Be Fought Alone, annual gala. It was a masquerade theme. It was an amazing night, a great turnout.
Yes,
again,
it was.
We appreciate everybody who was in attendance. Appreciate all those who donated that weren't able to be a part of the event. And we just want to thank you guys, because without you guys, all this stuff is not possible. Mm-hmm. So we greatly thank you, greatly appreciate you guys for coming out and donating. We're actually on our way to the last radiation right now, in a little bit of traffic, 10:30 appointment, but we'll get there. For those who don't know as well, we dedicated this fundraiser to two people. And this is probably our biggest project that we ever took on since we started the org.
Yeah.
So the first project is, it's a young man who goes to my high school that I graduated from, St. Raymond High School for Boys in the Bronx. And his mom recently passed away from cancer. And you know that we just don't deal with people from cancer, with cancer, I should say, because cancer is not the only battle that we face in this life and in this journey. It's a whole bunch of other things, whole bunch of other obstacles that come into our path that still needs all our undivided attention. And for those who can't provide for themselves, we are still here to help. So even though his mom did pass away from cancer, she left behind a 27-year-old daughter, and I believe he has a younger sibling as well. But all the finances were left on her. His sister. And going to Catholic school is really expensive. He's an athlete at the school, plays on the varsity A basketball team. And we just saw, it was a need, and we saw that we needed to be involved in this need and help this need. So for the next 2 years that he is in St. Raymond's, we're paying for half of his scholarship, half of his tuition. And if we could give more, we would definitely give more, because that's what we're all about. And the second person is a person who came recommended to us. We didn't know her story at first. And that's the amazing thing, because she didn't show any struggle or any weakness when we first met her. But It's a mother who, she's a hairdresser. She's actually living in a shelter, doesn't have money for food and stuff of that sort.
She has a baby.
She has a young daughter. She also has an older son who was taken away from her by her ex-husband and is in France. So any finances that she does come up with and does make, it's all going to like legal fees and stuff of that sort. So she is struggling. So with our connections, we're going to try to get her linked up with some, probably some better lawyers to try to see different ways we could go about helping her in that aspect. Try to find better shelter, better food, stuff of that sort. So we're definitely trying to tap in and help as many people and help her as well. So without further ado, the rest of this video will show you some amazing footage from that night. Shout out to my boy Jordan, the photographer, who did an amazing job.
Videographer.
He's a photographer as well.
Oh, sorry.
So shout out to Jordan. We appreciate you as well. Yeah, so stay tuned. You know what it is. Like, comment, share, subscribe to the channel. More amazing footage coming to you. Thank you. We out.
Doing all that you have done and all that you are going to do tonight. We give you thanks. We thank you for what you're doing in this organization. Thank you for making it beautiful in your sight, Father God. We just want to thank you for everyone that is here tonight. We thank you for the fellowship tonight, and I pray that you will be in the midst of us tonight as we fellowship with one another. Father, you know the reason and the purpose that we are here tonight. And that is the mission, Lord God, that we have stand with. No battle should be fought alone. So, Lord, we give you thanks tonight and we honor you as we come together, Lord God, to raise funds and to give thanks. So we give you all honor and we give you all glory as we open up tonight's event. In Jesus' name, amen.
And first, I'd just like to thank you all for coming out. And we're all looking stunning, if I do say so myself. Without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, I would like you to stand with me and welcome the founder, the vision that this young man has in bringing us all together this evening, none other than my son, Tristan
Dillon.
Appreciate you. Thank you. I just want to introduce my board members to everybody. Mother. Alright, never mind. I'm not here to give a speech, but it's just been something on my heart for the last couple days that I just wanted to share with each and every one of you in here today. It's amazing to see what the devil made for evil. God has turned it around and made it for his good. That alone is what brought us all here today. We are all here to celebrate life. The lives that we live, the lives that the people this organization plans on changing. The downfall in my life, in all reality, is my greatest victory. If my Savior fell down and got up, why can't I do the same? That alone, the support of family and friends, it's what keeps me going on the daily. I just want to leave you with this before we start our night. When life gets rough, don't quit. That is the devil trying to tell you that God is telling you it's okay to give up. Don't ever allow the devil to redefine who you are, and never allow him to redefine who God is. You know why? Because my God doesn't change. Don't run from difficulties, but be empowered by them. And allow them to empower your life, your gift, your mission. Your gift is given to you, but in all actuality, it's for the benefit of others. Your gift, in all reality, is where God has you currently placed now. I will forever give God all the praise, because it's not chemo, it's not doctors, it's only by God's grace why I'm still able to stand before you today. 14-hour surgery, stage 4 colon cancer diagnosis, tumors came back, no one can tell me that's not God. So before we continue tonight, can we give my God some praise? Is that okay? I can't hear you. Can we give our God some praise tonight? Can we get on our feet and give our God some praise? Let's give our God some praise tonight, because he's the reason why we're all here tonight. If you guys want to come out on the dance floor right now and give my God some praise right now, let's go. Let's go.
Every praise, every word of worship, my love for you.
it's a battle and we have to fight. And she told me to get up out of bed because I was in bed for a couple days. And I got up out of bed, started walking the halls, looking into other people's rooms, and I realized that nobody had anybody in their rooms with them. And I said, you know what? No matter where life may take me, because I kind of didn't know what was going to happen, I said, you know what? While I'm still here, I'm going to make a change. I'm going to make an impact on other people's lives. And I believe that's my calling. I'm a vessel, and I'm being used. Yes, this journey is long. It's painful. It's rough, and I don't wish it on anybody. But I'm living out my purpose. I'm living out my mission. I'm living out my gift, and that's just helping people. So this event, a boy that goes to my high school, well, not my high school anymore, but the high school I graduated from, he's, I believe, 16 years old, and his mom recently passed away from cancer, leaving all the finances to his 27-year-old sister. So what my organization is doing, and I'm very proud of this, for the next 2 years that he has remaining in high school, we'll be paying for half of his tuition for the next 2 years. And it's also another lady who came in my path, and she was super nice. Didn't really know that she was going through anything until somebody told me. She's homeless. She's living in a shelter. She has a young daughter, and her firstborn was taken away from her by her husband and went back to France. So she hasn't seen her child in years. So she works as a hairdresser. Whatever she makes is basically going to lawyer fees and stuff of that sort. So the organization is planning on doing whatever we have to do for her in terms of trying to find better shelter, providing for her kid in whatever way they need. And that's just where we fall in, and that's what we do. And that's why you guys are all here. You guys are all here supporting a vision, a mission that is bigger than yourselves. And that's exactly what cancer taught me, to live for something bigger than yourself. So going on into our night, dinner is being served right now, so I hope you guys enjoy that. And we'll be moving along with things. Thank you.
You guys can all follow me at Matt Violinist across the board. So it's MattViolinist. All right?
chop chop, real smooth. Turn it out. To the left. Oh yeah, I know you gotta do this dance. Here we go.
Everything is happy, shit, it's alright.